I'm off the track again at Popeye Tonga Reserve, and just having a look around. And I'm noticing all of these berries scattered around the ground. One there. They're in various stages of ripeness. There's another one. And I've checked them on my plant identifier. And apparently they are karaka nuts. K-A-R-A-K-A. So there's a green one and there's a riper one. The birds love them, apparently. They are, the flesh of the nut is, the berry is edible, but requires a special preparation method. And if they're not prepared correctly, they can be quite toxic, so unless you know the method, it's not worth giving it a go. Now I'm assuming that this is the tree that they're falling from. I can get a decent view of it. Pretty high. So I'm assuming that these are karaka trees. I can hear tui and possibly wood pigeons flying around the area at the moment, so they're probably eating them. But I'll carry on, see what else I can find. There's a fantail or two. And it sort of goes through here. The trail itself is reasonably clear to make out. But I want to go further off the track, so I want to try and get down into this gully here. See how far I can get. Biggest problem is Supplejack. It creates a bit of a tangle. Alright, see how far I can get. My friend the fantail, following me around, hoping I'll dislodge a few insects for him to catch. The supplejack's pretty dense around here. Not sure how far I can get. Not too bad if you can scout out a bit of a path ahead and go around some of these saplings. Oh, that's a bit of a tangle. Okay, do both ends. He's feeling happy with himself, he just caught himself a moth. A bit of a boggy area just here. I'm wearing my bear's feet. Feels nice. Nice under my feet. Sinking in a bit. Okay, where to from here? Getting pretty thick. Some huge trees. Quite a bit of standing water here. Being a low point in the terrain, that's where it all gathers. Looks like I might be able to get around through there. Nobody would have been around this way in a long time, if ever. Mud's getting a bit deep. As you can probably hear. A big fella. I think this is about as far as I'll get, I think. That water, standing water just ahead, looks pretty deep between the water and the mud underneath. So I might head back again. I've channeled my David Livingston for now. I'll see you shortly. Right, just came up out of the gully and I'm back on the possum baiters trail. But I might head east and back towards where the car's parked. Got a bottle of drinking water there and I'll wash off these filthy feet and bloody feet. Just a scratch. Then I might just head home. I've had my fun. First time I've seen one of these spiders in the webs. They're hard to focus. A little yellow fella. A yellow fella. I haven't got an insect to identify, so I'll take a close-up photo of them, or her, and see if I can identify it. No doubt it'll be a native. So I've frightened them away. Come on, focus. Okay, that's enough. I'll get going. Some more of the karaka berries or nuts. I imagine the possums will probably quite like them too, but there shouldn't be too many possums around here. There's all the baking that goes on. There's some different fungus on this huge tree that's fallen down. I don't know what they are, but I won't bother identifying them. Yeah, it's huge. Must have made a hell of a crash. I'm not sure what's going down here. I videoed a big Nikko palm, probably about the size of this one. Somebody dug around and created a root ball at the bottom. Obviously intending to come back at some point and cart it away. Now someone's already carted one away from here. Quite a big one, judging by the size of the hole. Now I don't know whether there are any laws against that, or whether perhaps local Māori might have customary rights to harvest fully grown Nikko palms, or perhaps certain garden centres might have permits. I don't know, someone's just stealing it. They're a bit difficult because they had a camera trained on the car park area. So it wouldn't be easy to cart that away. Anyway. Oh, there's the fence. Good. It's a post and rail fence, so it's easy to get over. Not like the barbed wire fence I had to clamber over the other day. Well, that was a bit of fun, clambering around in there, but now I've got to clean my feet off before I get in the car. Whoops, might be a bit dry. That'll probably do it. Okay, time to get off. We stopped off at the beach on the way home to wash my grubby feet off. And I'm going to have to be a bit careful, I think. These are all blue bottles that have been washed up. They've got nasty stings. Let's go and see what the water's like. It's a lot calmer for me. The water's a bit grubby though. Anyway, I'm going to head back to the car and head home. See you soon.